I met Herman, and I have to say that his energy when he was describing what he's doing with Improbable immediately struck a chord with me. I think what's common between me and Herman is taking on a big mission. He's trying to create a system where you can simulate large-scale problems that we're seeing in the world and applying modern computational technology to it to seeing what the possible outcomes could be. And we might not even know exactly who will be the first customers to what he is building, because there are so many different applications. But you know, he's taken on something really big and ambitious, and I think that's the thing which is really, really admirable.
I'm Herman Narula, I'm the CEO of Improbable. We're a company that's created a new kind of distributed operating system called Spatial OS. And it can be used to power massive scale simulations, new kinds of game worlds, new ways of building big distributed systems. Making Spatial OS a widely available service is really important because it'll help to create a foundation for people to build much more interesting things than we could build ourselves. We're so excited to be heading to Helsinki to start telling the whole world about Spatial OS and really making the case and making the signups open. We're very excited about what's going to happen. The kind of really exciting companies and projects that are going to be built on Spatial OS won't come from Improbable, they're going to come from our community and likely create a lot of success for other people. And that's very exciting for us because anything anyone builds, it improves the technology, it feeds back to us, and it creates an even bigger opportunity.
Hello. Hi. It's wonderful to be here and great to meet all of you. Today I want to talk about what could be the next big frontier in computing.
We want to make possible massive simulated worlds that can help us look at this world differently. So why not represent entire cities in simulations or represent a whole company or an economy? What could we learn about those systems by having that model? Take, for example, the possible impact of shutting down a tube station on a city. Without a simulation, we could guess at what that would be, but with a simulation, we could actually run that experiment. We could take a model of a city, we could shut down that tube station, and we could see how does it impact where people can get to? How does it impact commercial activity? What is the actual cost of it? Those are the sorts of models that would be very hard to build today, but developers can use Spatial OS to make that a reality. Today, games are an illusion of being in a world. As you walk around the world only exists when you're there. When you build a world on Spatial OS, it's a persistent universe where every entity exists even when you're not around. But with Worlds Adrift in Boss Studios, we see a world where every tree you cut down or every rock you blow up becomes something that other players can encounter. Every decision you make means something and matters. I hope that the projects people are going to build on Spatial OS will excite people in a way that they had always been expecting to be wowed and to see wonder. We've always been waiting for the promise of virtual worlds. There's so many fields that would benefit from being able to do really big models, and that to me, like, is the next frontier. So I think that, you know, we might be the first people doing this, but we definitely won't be the last.